spirits to leave him. They went into the pigs, and the pigs committed suicide. What that shows you is that what the demons did to the pigs, they intended to do to the man. But Jesus stopped. For some of y'all, you have mental issues. Hardest part to do is to admit is that you struggle mentally. And mental illness is real. But we blanket it with spirituality. They say, you just pray about it. No. You need help. And some of y'all need to help people get help. How do you get free from crazy family members? Like, that's how come when the Lord told Abraham, get thee out of that father's house, he ran out. You should study the Bible, because when they talked about taking his son back, he's like, whoa, promise me you'll never take my son back to what I came out of. How many of y'all never want your children to experience what you experience? How you deal with struggling? How many of y'all are just sick of being in bondage to debt? Like, bills come in, you just look up like, ugh. Never let an unidentified call come to your phone, you're not answering it. It is what it is. But what do you do when something has you? Amen, listen. What do you do when something has you? Like, what do you do when you don't like your weakness? It's going to get real quiet now. What if something pleases your flesh, but it upsets your spirit? And then after you do it, you feel like crap. You know, you get saved, and now you can't do that no more. What else am I going to do? Because I've been doing that for years. Why is it quiet in here?
Come on, Reverend.
You know, you used to get a shot every night before you go to bed. Just take it to the head. You know, you used to smoke it. You know, you used to sleep it around. And your flesh enjoyed it. Stop lying to Jesus. Oh, God, I did not enjoy it. Please stop lying. Be like, Lord, listen, I had a good time, but I know I'm wrong.
Let's go, Pastor.
What do you do when that thing got you? How do you get free from stuff that you hate? If you have your Bibles, I want you to go to Luke, the 7th chapter, and let me show you the pursuit of freedom. Now, one of the Pharisees invited Jesus to have dinner with him. So he went to the Pharisee's house and reclined at the table. When a woman who had lived a sinful life in that town learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house, pursued, she brought an alabaster jar of perfume. Pursued, she stood behind him at his feet weeping and began to wet his feet with her tears. Pursued, and then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and poured perfume on them. Pursued. But the Pharisees who had invited him saw this, he said to himself, if this man were a prophet, he would know who is touching him and what kind of woman this is. That she is jacked up. She's a sinner. Man, that thing got her. You know that it's bondage because in verse 37, look at the screen. When a woman who lived, I like the Bible because it doesn't tell all of her business. See, some of y'all are nosy. You want to know, well, what did she do? Same thing you're doing?
Talk, Reverend. Reverend, talk.
Who lived a sinful life in that town. This woman obviously has some things about herself that she does not like. And it's possible that she had heard Jesus say this one line. Look at the screen in John 8:36. So if the Son sets you free, if the Son sets you free, then you are free indeed, because you can't set yourself free. How many times have we tried it, but every time I try, I end up going. You go back to it. So how do you get out? How do you get out? How do you get out? It's just somebody, I want to be out, don't get you out. Lip service, I'm so sick of lip service. This is the year to get it. I need you to touch your neighbor and say, this is the year to get it. This is the year to get free. This is the year to come out of it. This is the year to walk around in liberty. Now, everybody listen to me. I feel as if my message is now a more mature. Because some of y'all, you want to shout, you want to dance, but then when you get done shouting and dance, you wipe your sweat and you do nothing. You speak in tongues, you do all this, and then when you get done speaking in tongues, you have done nothing to change your situation. Faith without works is. So how do you get free? Number one, she gives you the format to freedom. Number one, your freedom comes with a plan. It comes with a plan. What do you mean? In verse 37, the Bible says, when a woman who had lived a sinful life in that town, here it is, learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house, she got a plan to get to that house. She did not wait on Jesus to come to where she was. She had a plan. I need to get up, and I need to go to where he is. And I'm not going empty-handed. She didn't just shoot from the hip. She got up. She had a strategic plan. Commentary said the way that the house is set up, they had a big window where you could look up in the house. I'm sure she was walking by looking like, waiting on the right opportunity. But when I came with a plan. Nudge your neighbor and say, you need a plan. What is your plan? What is your plan? Look at the screen in Proverbs 21 and 5. Please watch this. The plans of the diligent leads to profit, as surely as haste leads to poverty. If you have a plan, then you're going to be profitable. If you're just shooting from the hip, you have nothing coming. Look at the screen. Psalms 20 and 4. May he give you the desires of your heart. Here it is. And make all your plans do what? Succeed. What is your plan? Watch me. You have no plan. Some of y'all are like Mephibosheth, who was lame, couldn't walk. He couldn't come out. He just waiting on somebody to come and get him. And David sent for him. Ever look at me. You are not handicapped. Nobody's coming to get you out. You better open this gate. Wait. Some of y'all are like Jacob. You want to have an encounter. You want to wrestle with the angel. Every Sunday you come in here, you just fall all out. You wrestle with angels. You speaking in tongues. You're on the flow. But when you get done wrestling, not what you gonna know. When you get done running around the building doing victory laps, when you get done running around the building, now you're sweating, your deodorant has, your roll-on has rolled off. What's your plan? I want to lose weight. I need to get out of debt. I'm sick of my marriage being in hell. How you gonna get it out? How you gonna get it out? Trust me. I don't like the way they treat me. All they do is come over here and sleep with me. Steps. He's going to hook you up. He's going to hook you up with the right people that you need to meet. You're going to nap when somebody steps to you. You're going to look at your plan and say, but that doesn't go what I asked God to do for me. Everything that comes to you is sacrifice. Please listen. She brought an alabaster jar perfume. I gotta give up something to get something. Woo, we better come through here now. We want to be free, but we don't want to give up nothing. Oh, y'all ain't gonna say that to me. You want to get out of debt, but you want to shop every weekend. Y'all ain't gonna say that to me. Come on here, come on here. Come on here, y'all, please. I didn't expect it to be this quiet. God, please help me to preach this. These demons are fighting me, Lord. What's your sacrifice? She gets a jar of perfume, an alabaster jar of perfume. She goes in, now watch me. The way that the Bible said he was reclined at the table, everybody look at me. The way that they ate was that they ate like this. They would get down, they would eat, but they would recline like this. When they recline like this, they would eat in a circle while they were eating. She has a sacrifice. She gets behind him and she brings her own perfume to the house. She then gets behind him and say, listen, it ain't just my resources I'm going to give him, but she puts her body into it. The Bible says that she began to wash his feet with her tears. She pointed her tears in his direction. Come on here. The Bible says that a woman's hair is her glory. She unwrapped her hair, which means that I don't have any pride in this situation. When she let her hair down and her tears are hitting his feet, she began to wash his feet with her tears and dry them with her hair. Y'all not saying nothing to me. And then she got affectionate with him. She just started kissing his feet. Kissing his feet. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you my resources. I'm going to give you my tears. I'm going to release my pride. And I'm going to show you that I mean business by kissing your feet. Some of y'all, you didn't even come here today. And all you do is just sit here. You sit here because you don't want nobody to see you cry. Let me tell you something. Because you don't want your makeup to run. Don't wear it. Come on here. Never get your hair so done that you can't give God glory. Y'all ain't saying that to me. What is your sacrifice? Come on, watch me. What is your sacrifice? Even when the two blind men hooked up together, they might not have eyes, but I have a voice. And the Bible said, and they heard that Jesus was coming back. This is why I tell you, please make sure you sit next to somebody who's willing to release a sacrifice like you. The Bible says that when Jesus went back, they just began to holler, hey! The Bible said that the crowd began to rebuke them and tell them that they were too loud. Isn't it amazing? And those that have it tell you it don't take all of that. But if you sit next to somebody who desperate, like you desperate, I can't get no help in here. You will open your mouth. I need you to release a sacrifice right now. Open your mouth. Lift your hands. It's a sacrifice. She has a plan. She has a sacrifice. Now watch me. Watch me. Watch me. Some of y'all, you gotta hear me. We don't want to give up nothing. You just want to be free. But what are you willing to give up? What are you willing not to do? Let me show you what I mean. You ready? Let's go to sacrifice. Let's go here. Jesus said this. He says, if anyone wants to come up to me, you got to sacrifice. You got to deny yourself something. You got to deny yourself something. You have to deny yourself something. She has a plan. She has a sacrifice. She has warfare. Your freedom comes with warfare. I'm coming through now. You ready? Your freedom comes with warfare. And everybody hear me. And most of the time, your warfare is people. Everybody don't want to see you free. Everybody listen to me. How warfare. You want freedom. But you worried about what somebody think about you. Yes, God. Everybody look at me. Everybody look at me. Look. What do you mean warfare? What do you mean warfare? Why is she doing all this? Look at the screen. The Bible says when the Pharisee who had invited Jesus into his house saw this, he said to himself, which means that he has an opinion about her desperation. It will blow your mind how many people have an opinion about your desperation. Watch me. Watch me. He was a punk because he didn't have the nerve to say it out loud. And there are a lot of people, they don't have the nerve to say it in your face, but they discuss it behind your back. And it caused difficulty in the spirit realm. I come against every piece of warfare that wants to stop you from being who God has called you to be. Please, y'all, you need backup in the spirit realm. Please, can you touch your name and say, I'm believing God for us. Make sure you touch desperate. Make sure you touch somebody who want to be free. Make sure you're not sitting next to your warfare. In my shot. Make sure you're not sitting next to your warfare. I need you to make sure you sit next to somebody who want to be free like you want to be free. I need you to make sure you sit next to somebody who believe God like you believe God. Please, one more time, touch your name and say, I'm believing God for us. I can fight outside, but I can't fight in here. When I come to church, at least put me next to somebody who believe that God is able to do anything. You had to fight at your house. You had to fight on your job. At least when I come in the building, let me not sit next to another witch or warlock. Let me sit next to somebody who believes. Shake your pew. Make sure you ain't got no warfare on your pew. Look down your ear and say, let's give God some glory right here. Let's praise God for what's about to happen for us in 18. Let's give God glory for the doors that are about to open for us. Let's open our mouths and release the praise. You got warfare. Your freedom comes with warfare. Your freedom comes with warfare. Your freedom comes with warfare. And he thought to himself, if he were a real prophet, he would know that this woman that's touching him ain't right. But watch me, please. It wasn't just the warfare of him thinking. It was the warfare of the disciples who were just looking. Come on here. You cannot tell me that she was the only one in the house that had an issue. But at least she was bold enough to say, listen, I'm going to give y'all the opportunity to do it. And if y'all don't do it, I'm going to have to go out here by myself. I don't like having to come to church and have to praise God by myself. I feel like I should be able to sit next to you and automatically a fire come through here. But guess what? If you don't want to praise him, if you don't want to go out there, then I'm willing to. I want to see if you're willing to go out there by yourself. See, some of y'all, I just want to see if you're willing to just shout by yourself. I just want to see if you're willing. Touch your neighbor and say, you need a plan? Yeah. Touch your neighbor again and say, you need some sacrifice? Yeah. Touch your neighbor again and say, you got warfare? Yeah. You got a plan? You got some sacrifice? And you got some warfare? Here's the line that messed me up. Coming out of this, I'm going to go to where he is, and I'm going to gather some stuff. I'm going to bring my sacrifice. I don't care what nobody think. I got some warfare. Some of y'all looking at me like I'm crazy. But I'm going to get where Jesus is, and I'm going to be consistent in my position. I'm going to wait, but I'm going to be consistent in what I do. I'm going to keep crying, I'm going to keep wiping, and I'm going to keep kissing. I'm going to keep crying, I'm going to keep wiping, and I'm going to keep kissing. I'm going to keep crying, I'm going to keep wiping, and I'm going to keep kissing. He ain't paying you no attention, it don't matter. I'm going to keep crying, I'm going to keep wiping, and I'm going to keep kissing. And then he finally turns and he looks at Simon and he says, Simon, I know what you're thinking. Why is he talking to Simon? Simon ain't crying. Simon ain't wiping. And Simon ain't kissing. I ain't thinking about Simon. I'ma keep crying. I'ma keep wiping. I'ma keep kissing. I'ma keep crying. I'ma keep wiping. And I'ma keep kissing. And look, watch me. Why is he not talking to you? It don't matter. He can't ignore my worship. I'ma keep crying. I'ma keep wiping. And I'ma keep kissing. I'ma keep crying. I'ma keep wiping. And I'ma keep kissing. But he ain't talking to you. I started kissing in 38. He ain't 38. He ain't talking to 48. But I'ma keep crying. I'ma keep wiping. I'ma keep kissing. I'ma keep coming to church, giving God glory. You don't like me? It don't matter. You might talk about me? I don't care. I'ma get on the altar. I'ma give God glory. I'ma keep crying. I'ma keep wiping. I'ma keep kissing. I'ma come to 4 a.m. prayer. You might talk about me. You don't like me? It don't matter. I'ma keep crying. I'ma keep wiping. I'ma keep kissing. This is my spot. Don't be in my spot when I get there. You know I always stay right here. I've been faithful. I've been consistent. I'ma keep crying. I'ma keep wiping. I'ma, some of y'all, you stop crying. You stop wiping. You stop kissing. You about to get an answer. Lift your hands. Watch me. I'm looking at some of y'all. You ain't crying like you used to cry. You ain't wiping like you used to wipe. And you ain't kissing like you used to kiss. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Who stopped you from crying? Who stopped you from getting on the altar?
Yeah.
Who stopped you from coming to Bible study like you used to come? Who told you to get off the altar? Stop praying like you used to pray. Who shut your prayers down? What happened to your praise? Your praise was amazing. Your praise made me want to go after God. All of a sudden now you just stand up in here. You're not a stander. You're a worshiper. Where my worship is at? I need my worshipers. Get back on your pulse. 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 Look at me. Freedom comes with a plan. Freedom comes with sacrifice. Freedom comes with warfare. And people are your problem. People are your issue. That's part of your freedom. That you get past people and get to Jesus. I can tell you're not ready because you're still worried about what they think. This song, I don't mind waiting. So give me this man. I don't mind waiting. Everybody look at me. I want you to hear me clearly. I've been saved for 37 years. 30 plus years. 37 years. I can say that 17. 54. And at 17, I found myself on the altar, lifting my hands, giving God glory. One of my friends sent me a picture that I was at the convocation, and I was in my early 20s, and I used to only sing in the choir so I could get a seat close to the altar.
was the only reason I sang in the choir. Half the time, I didn't know the songs. I was just moving my lips. But I did it so that I could get close to the fire. And there was a bishop called J.O. Patterson. And when he preached his last sermon, I was in the choir stand, and the camera zoomed in on me in my early 20s with my hands lifted, weeping before God. Here I am. There's some individuals in this building and some things you want freedom. I need you to commit at the beginning of the year. I'm going to stick to the plan. I'm going to bring my sacrifice. I will endure the warfare. Listen to this. And I will remain consistent. Ye did run well. Who stopped you? If you know that you kind of pull back some, I want you to get out of your seat, meet me on the altar, because it's commitment Sunday. It's commitment Sunday. I'm committed to this year. Come on, get out of your seat, man. Go, come on. Come on. Come on. I will keep crying. Put it in me to keep crying. Put it in me to keep wiping. Put it in me to keep kissing. Put it in me to do what I do. Make sure that I'm always on my pulse. Come on, lift your hand, just say yes, Lord. Come on, say one more time, say yes, Lord. Say yes, I'm committed to the plan. Come on, say yes, I'm committed to giving you sacrifice. This is deep right here. Say yes, I'm committed to the warfare. Even looking for. But you Lift your hands. Sacrifice. I need a commitment that you will go through whatever you have to go through, but that you will remain consistent. Staying home is not an option. Doing what God called me to do is not a choice. I gotta do it. Come on, lift your hands. Just say yes. Come on, say yes. Say yes, with tears running down. Come on, I know some of y'all are tired, but I hear the Lord about to give you strength right now. He's about to give you what you need so that you can remain consistent in doing what you do. Come on, Jonathan, tell the Lord yes. Come on, 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 Brandon, God got you, God got you. Come on, tell the Lord. You to make sure you're around somebody else. Grab your neighbor by the hand. Just hold that hand. We're going to be like the 10 lepers. We're about to shout until he pay us some attention. I'm talking to somebody. You've been sitting in the house, but the house is not where your ministry is. I'm talking to somebody. You've been sitting in a pew when God has put too much in you for you to be sitting in a pew doing absolutely nothing. You are a prayer warrior. You are a kingdom changer. God has invested too much in you for you to be sitting back doing absolutely nothing. You have been feeling as if you are stale, no movement. You want to know why? Because you are a pourer. You're somebody who's supposed to be pouring. God is ready to use you this year and ready for you to be consistent. Your deliverance is going to come in your plan. Your deliverance is going to come in your sacrifice. Your deliverance is going to come in your consistency. Hold that hand. Yes, 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 yes. Back on my square, yes, yes. Back to the script, yes, yes. Back to doing what you called me to do, yes, yes, yes. I'll say, I'll do it, yes, God. I'll do it, I'll take up my cross, I'll take up my cross. Come on, Benny, God has a will for our lives. Yes, Lord, yes, hold that hand, yes, 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 yes. Yes, God. 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 Come on. And we're about to let you leave in a few minutes. When I count three, I need you to shout yes, like you don't want Jesus to pass you by. I want you to say yes like your life is dependent on it. I need you to say yes because you got a plan that needs to be carried out. I need you to get ready, Denton. I need you to tell the Lord yes. I need some of y'all to get back on your square on the count of three, Stephen. I need you to open your mouth and shout yes. You got a hand. I need you to shout like I shout one. Put a yes in us, God. Put a yes in us to do your will. Put a yes in us to be successful this year. Put a yes in us to go through the warfare. Put a yes in us to be consistent. Put a yes in us to remain on the altar. Put a yes in us just so your will can be done. Two meetings right here. You ready? You ready? Your life is about to change. Are you ready? It is three.
Get up out of your seat, and I'm gonna need you to walk towards me on this altar.
your walk, lest the enemy know that it's time for change in your life. You can't change you. Some of y'all try, it's not working. You must get where Jesus is. If you know I'm talking to you, there's one, get out of your seat. Get out of your seat and start walking this way. Get up and come down. There's one. Just stand right there. She's not the only one. I feel you in this one. I feel you. But I don't know people looking at me. That's their problem. You got to get past you. You got to get past you. Get out of your seat right now. I am begging you to come to freedom right now. If you know I'm talking to you, get up out of your seat. And there's another. Start moving. Move. I need prayer movements to start praying. Move. Move. Get out of. There's another. Move. 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 There's another. Move. Move. Come for your future. There's one more person in this room. 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 There you go. Move. Move. It's free now. It's free. You are in this building right now. And the Lord say, today is the day that now the ball is in your court. You get up out of your seat and you come to me now. I'm gonna count to 10. I'm done. I've done my part. 10, move. 9, move. 8, move. 7, move. 6, move. 5, move. 4, give my shot. Move. 3, move. 2, I need everybody to release a praise in this building right here. Your offering. Get your seat ready. You need an humble raise your hand. they'll bring it to you. For those that are online, Periscoping us, whatever you can, so online. If you want to text it, give me just text the words N-O-C-S-E to 41444. Come on, get your seat ready. Get your seat ready. Everybody say, freedom looks good on me. You look good with no stress. Come on, if you're going to text it, give me, you're going to text the words N-O-C-S-E to 41444. For those that are giving absolutely nothing, wow. No sacrifice today. You have nothing to present to the Lord. Are you only following him for the fishes and the loaves? But can you give of your substance so that others can feast? Come on, get your seat ready, stand to your feet. Lift your seat up to the Lord and repeat after me, my Tyler Nicodemus. And I am blessed beyond measure. I have more than enough. I'm living in my overflow. Come on, say this. I am living in Ephesians 3:28. You can give your seat on your way out the door. Walk in the liberty of the Christ that set you free. And be not in